Pariah Sinclair. I'm a Baltimore drag queen. Pariah, she is campy, she is glamorous, and she is a fucking bitch. The inspiration behind Pariah was basically I mold myself after a housewife. So I'm like, I call myself Baltimore's only housewife. So she is glamorous, she is delusional, she is over the top, and she's beautiful. I want to give off the illusion that I don't live in a one-bedroom apartment in Baltimore, Maryland. So that is very all of this. This, like the robes and the jewelry and everything is giving the illusion. So Pariah is just exaggeration. Exaggeration in femininity, exaggeration in wealth, exaggeration in every aspect.
Where did the name Pariah come from?
Pariah, so it's not, like people always ask, it's not a great story. Basically, when I was 20, I wasn't even thinking about like doing drag, like even as a hobby, I was doing it. I was hosting like the drag show at Towson University where I went. And my boyfriend at the time, we were thinking of names, and he came up with Pariah. So if you don't know, Pariah is like a social outcast, which I identify with as being, you know, a queer person. You know, when I was younger, I was bullied. I relate to being an outcast. But the word Pariah, it sounds very nice. It sounds kind of like glamorous and like, not like, what's the word? Kind of just like elegant, but has like a dark meaning, which I kind of like. And then Sinclair kind of flows with it. Pariah Sinclair flows. And Sinclair has a very like bougie Caucasian sound to it. So that kind of fits the aesthetic I was trying to give. And also no one has Pariah. Like no other drag queen has it, so.
How has your style and look evolved over the years?
It's gotten more polished. Cause I think I always knew like what I, like who Pariah was and what the aesthetic was. I just, you know, after time, like working, getting more gigs, getting more money, just the aesthetic has, you know, polished and has gotten a little more glamorous, gotten a little more put together. I have a little more coin to spend. So, and also I've been able to like become more creative, and like my looks and my performances have evolved, and they got more. I have been able to edit more. I would say I've been able to edit more in all aspects of my drag.
What's your favorite thing about doing drag?
Just being creative and making people laugh, entertaining people, making that drag show or that event the highlight of someone's day.
Shit, isn't that weak? I know the sun not out, but we gonna have us a good time. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is India Lorel Houston, and I will be your hostess and MC this evening. Make some noise. I hope everybody's ready to have a wonderful time. We got some amazing entertainment. We're gonna do a couple of dance-offs, because that's the fuck I feel like. We are gonna have a good time. Are y'all ready for a good time? Yeah. Y'all can do a little bit better than that, baby. Yeah. All right, we getting there. Please make some noise for our very first entertainer, Chanel! We'll be right back. green goddess, Miss Anita Mason!
The tall, the tantalizing, the one and the only, the giraffe herself, Miss Pariah Sinclair! Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You have a wonderful night. Good night!
How do you get yourself ready for a gig?
Like, mentally ready or, like, physically ready?
Whichever you're willing to share.
So how do I getting myself ready for a gig, I guess the obvious is, like, painting my face. But I think trying to get in the mindset, I like to, like, listen to music, like, to watch TV. I like to just kind of just take my time. I hate rushing for gigs. So just trying to get in the right mental space. Because once I rush and, like, I'm trying to, like, make it to a gig, it just kind of goes downhill from there.
Yeah, so this is my Cash App Venmo dress, which it has. You can see it's been through a little bit. I'm gonna get a whole new outfit made that has, like, all forms of, like, payment on the outfit. But, so this is the front is Cash App. In the back is Venmo, because she is a business queen. Because especially in this day of age, in the height of COVID, just cash was not, you know, the most safe, so we turned to, like, digital payment, which we're still doing, so it just makes it easier for people just to tip me. I have this money cover-up, which I start out with for numbers, and it reveals to this, because she is a conceptual and has a look. This dress, which I really like, it's very old-school pageant-y. So he has, like, the big sleeves, good old, like, curtain flower print, and, you know, I had to add a little sparkle with the stones. So, yeah, and as you could tell, I am splitting my closet, so this is my drag stuff, and my boy stuff is here. This is the closet of a working drag queen. So, and then this, I love this. This is my good old little housewife walk around. A little, you know, little pinup moment. And I just got this. This is very sexy, you know, very seductive. I added these chains. So I love that. And then I just got this piece weeks ago. It's a big old row, so much fabric, very housewife, very my aesthetic. So yeah, I need to put her in the dry cleaners though. Okay. And then these are the wigs that need to be styled, or they just look a little like throw-on wigs. This one's been seeing some things, but yeah, this is the wall of wigs. So yeah. So my first performance in drag was an absolute mess. It was a competition, I believe it was at the Depot in 2016. And the competition was like a lip sync battle style competition. So there was like eight of us, and then we would go two by two. What did I perform? What was it? Oh my god, it was so long. 5 years ago, it was Lady Gaga, and we did Marry the Night. I actually knew all the words. I was surprised. But it was a whole fucking mess. I had no pads. I had this awful shake and go wig. It was like a blonde. I barely glued on my brows. I was just hopping all over the place. It was an absolute mess. But yeah, that was my first time performing. So I would say, like, right now the support my friends and family is amazing. They totally encourage, like, whatever I do when it comes to drag. I see my parents, when, like, I first started drag, I think they were just, like, kind of over. Because I was consistently coming out to them. I, like, was first bi, then I was gay, and then I was a drag queen. So it was just a lot for them to take in. And also, up until, like, recently, I think they've begun to understand, like, the impact of drag and how big drag is and, like, what I can do with drag. And it's more than a hobby of me just putting on makeup and, you know, flailing my body around. It's a business. It's, you know, it can be lucrative. But also, I think, especially for my dad, when he's seen how much money I can make out of it, he kind of took it a little more seriously.
But yeah, I mean, they're very supportive, but I think with parents, they just want me to find a balance, not to overwhelm myself, because before the pandemic, I was definitely becoming overwhelmed with drag and taking on too much. But yeah, my friends, a lot of my friends are in drag or drag performers, but my friends that don't do drag, they love it. They love that I'm doing well and that I'm happy and comfortable with myself and everything. So yeah.
So what's some advice you would give to a beginning queen?
The advice I would give to a beginning queen is don't do it. I'm kind of kidding, but I'm kind of not. Advice I would give to a queen or drag performer is find out if you really want to do this. Drag is a lot. It's a lot of work. So find out if you actually have the passion for it. And then once you find out you have the passion for it, then figure out your persona, figure out your aesthetic, figure out everything that goes into drag before you get on that stage. That's because a drag is like 10% performing, probably less than that when it comes to performing. And also just like make sure that you're like mentally ready for this. It's a lot of fucking work, drag. It's not easy. A lot of times when people come into drag, not a lot, but some people when they come into drag, they think drag is gonna be like a sisterhood, it's gonna be this like great thing, and they're gonna like have friendship, and a lot of times it doesn't happen. So yeah, I would just think like coming in with like no expectations.
Is there anyone, like, would you want to be a drag mom?
No, at this moment, I answered that very quickly. So at this moment in my life, I would not want to be anyone's drag mom. I've had a couple people ask me recently, and I've shot them down, like, very, very hard. I'm so focused on, like, getting my shit together. Because I think, like, a drag mom is more than a title. A drag mom is more than just giving someone your last name. It's like a mentorship, and I'm not at that space yet to like fully help somebody and like make sure they are like together. Because at the end of the day, like if you're someone's drag mom, that's your, like, you know, they have your name, or you know, figuratively and literally, they have your name, you know, and that's a resemblance of you. So you know, if you're not a good drag mom and they're looking at a hot ass mess, That's gonna be a symbol of you. So, yeah, I mean, I'll help anyone. If anyone asks for help, I will help them. I've helped a lot of people, in the city or, you know, in general. If anyone has a question about drag, how they like it started, what they need, you know, any links to like buy stuff, I will definitely help them, but I will never be anyone's, in this present moment in my life, I will never be anyone's drag mom.
How do you feel about RuPaul's Drag Race?
I mean, I love RuPaul's Drag Race as a reality show, as like a television program. You know, there's pros and cons to it as it pertains to the drag scene at large. Has been a way for drag queens in general to make a living off of drag without doing pageants, without competing on anything. So I think that's great.
Nara's bitch.
She's my name.
Like, breaking.
own words, how would you describe drag, especially to someone who has no idea who it is?
I would describe drag as an exaggeration of gender. And then there's a difference between like being a drag artist and being a drag performer. So, but yeah, just playing with gender exaggeration.
How would you describe Baltimore drag? Is it any different than different cities?
Yeah, I mean, I would definitely say Baltimore drag is different. It's different than other cities. Like, we definitely have a smaller scene. It's very, like, the Baltimore art scene in general is very DIY, very do-it-yourself. So there really isn't, like, because other cities have, like, drag bars or, like, get, like, yeah, so we're, like, there's drag, like, if not every night of the week, like, most nights of the week. And we don't really have that yet, at least. So I think it's so a lot of us drag performers have to take it on ourselves to create our own gigs. So it's definitely, like, a very, like, entrepreneurial, like, business, like, hustler mindset in Baltimore.
What's your favorite thing about performing in Baltimore?
Favorite thing about performing in Baltimore, just, I mean, in general, I just, like, I love meeting people. I love meeting people that hasn't never been to a drag show. I love connecting with the community. Yeah, I think it's definitely a great way to connect with the city I live in.
What do you believe makes drag queens so lovable?
What makes drag queens so lovable? I think people love us because we come off fearless. We come off being afraid to be ourselves, not being afraid to play with gender, to be, you know, over the top, be, you know, crazy, campy. I think people see us as being courageous, and I think, yeah. And kind of, I think people see us as something that they wish they could be, so I think that's why people are kind of drawn to drag queens. My proudest accomplishment when it comes to drag, I'm trying to think. I have done a lot with drag over my 5 years. I guess, but honestly, being able to perform like consistently, the fact is, like, right now I'm kind of overwhelmed a little bit, so I have an opportunity to say no to gigs, is probably a big accomplishment for me. Having the option, you know. I'm grateful that I have my own shows, I'm grateful that people are asking me to do their shows, so yeah, being buffed, honestly.
Very, very good friend, all the way from this back curtain, for Pariah Sinclair!